locked.
Sign of him now.
Got it.
Protectron on duty.
That's it.
Found a new frontier of foul. What a bunch of junk. To waste otherwise.
Identify yourself. Law-abiding citizens will not be harmed.
What the? tries to leave, kill him.
You must be pretty strong to make it here.
Who are you supposed to be?
I'm Slag, and we are the Forged. And you, stranger, you're somebody with some guts. I like that. See, Jake? Here's someone who might actually be worth my time. Unlike you.
You're gonna kill me.
But I brought everything you asked for.
Stealing things from your family farm doesn't prove your strength, boy. Though this wonderful sword you brought does put me in the mood to give you one last chance to prove your worth. What do you say? Kill that prisoner and prove that you aren't completely useless.
You said we'd be raiding outside the Commonwealth. These people aren't even a threat to us.
Prove to me that you can kill! It's him or you.
Oh God, what do I do? What do I do?
Walk away, Jake. You don't have to do this.
Please, let me go!
What's
You're
it
right.
gonna be, Jake?
I don't want to do this.
I don't want to join the Forged. I just want to go home.
Last chance.
I guess he didn't recognize him to fall and let his
Hey there.
Thanks a lot. Thought I was gonna die back then.
Hey there.
Wait, I'm sorry. I messed up. I panicked.
Always happy to help.
I don't know what I was thinking trying to join them. Look, I should probably try to go home and make amends. I know I've got no right to ask, but I bet if you're there to explain, things with my dad would go easier. I bet if you bring my great-granddad's sword, he'll make it worth your while. He always tries to deal fair with people. I'll wait for you by the overpass near the farm.
Hey.
Shoot.
Hi. I'm so nervous. I feel like I'm gonna throw up. Here goes nothing.
What the? Boy, I told you that
Abraham,
if you showed your face
on?
Here again, I'd...
Is that my boy come home?
What? Jake's back? Oh, thank God. Papa, please. I know I screwed up pretty big. I thought if I joined up, I could keep them from raiding our farm. I didn't. I don't want to hurt anybody.
I don't care what you thought. I told you.
Abraham Francis Finch, that's enough.
Mama, it...
Shut up, Jake. If I hear anything out of either of you, you'll both be peeling potatoes for the next year. I've watched you two go at it for years and tried to let you sort it out for yourselves. Abraham, your son is a grown man. And if you expect him to act like one, then you'd better stop treating him like a child. Jake, your father and I have been out there, and we know it can be dangerous. We just want to make sure you're prepared. There, it's over. And if I hear another word about it from either of you, so help me.
She's right.
Jake, thanks again for getting me out of there.
Abraham.
She's right. I've been a fool. There's no way I can thank you enough. Here's something for your help. I think you should hang on to that sword. It'd put a smile on Granddad's face to know it was being used to help people.
Hey.
Thanks again for getting me out of there.
If we had a good supply of clean water...
Thanks again for getting me out of there.
Thank you.
Something's out there. You really held your own there, Blue. What I wouldn't give for the biggest rolled up newspaper. That's all of them.
That's it.
This place is off limits. You'd best move along.
Edward Deegan sent me. I'm looking for a missing package.
Oh, you're the new guy. So this package, pretty sure we know where it is. The guys that shot Ben are holed up in the Parsons Creamery, just north of here.
Thanks for your help.
Now, if you'll excuse us, we've got a package to recover.
Sure thing. Hey, be careful. It's weird that they're still hanging around so close. Normal raiders would have grabbed the loot and bugged out by now. It's like they're scouting the place or something. I'll be glad when you clear them out.
Hey.
What can I do? Blue, you got a minute?
Sure thing.
Just what you said about Nat. I've been going over it again and again in my head, and what you said was right. Family's too precious. What kind of life is she gonna have if I never go near her again? It's just, sometimes it feels like the only things I've got in life are Nat and the paper. Having someone I can count on, someone like you, it's meant a lot to me. Not a lot of people want to hang around with a nosy reporter.
Yeah, but you're my kind of nosy.
You're the exception. I haven't exactly made a lot of friends in this career. I just wanted to right the things I thought were wrong. And when Nat and I first got to Diamond City, there was a lot of wrong. Crooked guards, lousy infrastructure. There was a hole in the exterior wall that was patched over with a bookcase. One bookcase. That's it. I started the paper more as an act of desperation than anything else. Turned out I wasn't the only one who wanted things to change. After the first couple of editions, people may not have agreed with what I said, but everyone was listening.
Sounds like you really cleaned up Diamond City.
Well, a lot of things got done. They even put a second bookshelf over that hole and patched it with bricks. When that first edition hit the stands, I felt like I'd finally done something worth doing. But afterwards, things changed. People didn't want to talk the way they used to. It seemed that overnight I'd gone from being Piper, friend and confidant, to Piper, the nosy snoop. A lot of folks, they haven't treated me the same since. It started to feel like the only person I could count on was my little sis.
You can count on me, Piper.
I know I can. You're not afraid of me like everyone else. I was sure that the paper would be the best thing I ever did in my life, but being here with you now, I don't know. I've needed someone like you in my life for a long time, Blue. I just never expected I'd actually get them. So thank you for being the friend I can count on.
It sounds to me like you're interested in becoming more than just friends.
Oh, I mean, well, I'd be lying if I said I never thought about you that way. Not that I'm always thinking that way. It's just, Blue, I'm loud and pushy and constantly getting in over my head. Why would someone like you ever want someone like me?
You don't need to be flawless, Piper. You're perfect for me.
Perfect, huh? That's a new one. Well, well, I think you're perfect too. Goodness, Blue, I don't know what to say. You're everything I could ever ask for. Come on, let's not keep the world waiting.
Heads up.
What you look like you could use a pick-me-up.
I think we're done for now.
If you're sure, I guess I'll head home. Just, don't keep me waiting.
Just don't bring any trouble down on us.